Welcome to this brief guide on using the advanced web interface on Mastodon. For those that have made the recent switch to Mastodon from other services like Twitter, you may well be familiar with services like Tweetdeck or the app Tweeten on Windows to enable a more advanced interface for your particular site, and then heading to your Mastodon instance and just seeing a left-hand pane for creation of posts and content searches, and then the middle column for your current timeline that you're viewing, and then the right-hand column for your settings and quick links to all of your different timelines. This may not look like it's advanced enough based on what you're used to. Sure, you have the ability to click on the Show Settings button and do a little bit of customization to the timeline that you're viewing, but Mastodon has an advanced web interface built in natively that has a lot of similarities to TweetDeck. Selecting the Preferences option will bring us around to our Preferences setting, and it's straight away to the Appearance settings, and we can select the Enable Advanced Web Interface. Make sure that we click on Save Changes in order to make this change apply to our account, and we'll get a lovely little confirmation that our changes have been saved. Now we can head back to Mastodon. And now you'll notice we have a lot of extra space available to us, and we're going to really make use of that space before this video is finished. Here I have my quick bar at the top with options to head to my home timeline, my notifications, my local timeline, the federated timeline, and then finally preferences, and last but not least, logging out of my service. Selecting any of these options will fill in this right-hand menu bar, which is by default the Getting Started bar. So first I'm going to select my home timeline, and you'll notice that the Getting Started bar has now converted across to my home timeline. But if I wanted to, I could also change it to maybe something like my notifications. But this isn't really making much use of that extra space that I have available to me. So what I'm actually going to do is a feature of the advanced web interface where I'm going to select my timeline in question, and then I'm going to select that Show Settings button like we did on the regular web interface. But I now have a third option which allows me to pin this timeline simply by clicking that button. And now that timeline is pinned, and my Getting Started column has now moved one step further over. Now if I select, say, my local timeline, I now have my local timeline and my home timeline at the same, in the same visibility for me, and I can also pin this just like before. But there was also a separate option there that allows me to filter out content in the local timeline to only show me posts that have media attached. This is great if you just want to have a quick feed of the imagery and don't want to necessarily pay attention to all the text-based posts. Now I could keep using these quick options here, but I can also click on the options in the Getting Started column itself to convert a column over. In the case of my federated timeline, you can see that that's a lot of content coming in thick and fast. So if I want to slow this down at any point, I can simply scroll my mouse wheel at any point here, and that will stop the feed from moving around. But as you can see from the scroll bar here, the content is still coming in. And if I want to jump myself back up to the top of the federated timeline, I can simply click on the option that says federated timeline, and this will continue to bump me up the feed. Now, just like other columns, I have options to filter out based on media only if I wish, but I can also filter the option that says remote only, and this will remove users that are on my local instance of Mastodon, and I don't need them in my federated timeline purely because they're already in my local timeline. This allows me to really customize the site to my own personal needs. I can still use the Explore tabs just like normal and see popular posts, hashtags, or anything that's designed for me. And then I've got a couple of last little things that we can show you as well. So I'm going to select over to my notifications, and then I'm going to click on the settings option, but wow, there are so many options when it comes to notifications. So here I can actually really customize what I'm going to do. I'm going to enable the display all categories for the quick filter bar, which we'll cover in a moment. But then I can have really granular control to customize my notifications for all the different forms of notifications that I could potentially get on Mastodon. And as I scroll all the way down to the bottom, I have the option to pin my notifications, which I'm going to do. And now we can talk about that quick filter bar. This allows me to quickly filter out my notifications just for the particular types of notifications I want, whether it be mentions, people favoriting my posts, people deciding to give me a bit of a boost, which is always welcome, any polls that I may well have either sent out or voted in myself. And if I have any profile post notifications that I've enabled, they will also show up in there as well. Now, obviously, these are the default things. I still have my option on the site here where I can create my own content or search. One of the things to note is you can even pin searches for particular hashtags or feeds, which is a great way to follow along with potentially a sporting event or something like that. And that is how you use the advanced web interface on Mastodon. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes your Mastodon experience in the future even better. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.